Hey there! Welcome to an unofficial video in which I will share a few ideas with you about the Liskov substitution principle. What do you know about it? Very frequently, it happens that I make a video on something, on modifying behavior of a class in one way, and then I get a question that literally reads, "Doesn't it break LSP?" The Liskov principle. My answer here was a bit detailed. It doesn't break the LSP per se, but a concrete implementation could. Like with any other method, so technically you can break LSP, but by changing a method in a derived class, you still didn't break anything. You don't break LSP by just overriding or supplying in any other way. An alternate implementation of the method. The conversation goes by another question. If I implemented a new or hiding method which doesn't function like the base method, then running the base class unit tests on an object of that derived class would fail, right? No, not right. You must define what doesn't function like the base method means. That's the point. Because some changes in the implementation will break LSP and some will not. LSP is about proving properties. So you must say which property stops being provable after changing a method. Very specifically, what makes you think in advance that a unit test would fail if it encountered a changed method implementation? Now we are stepping to a technical field, and I ask, if you ever thought that some change in the method implementation will break LSP, or that it is breaking LSP because it is somehow different than the base implementation, then I ask you, okay, if there is a unit test written while there was only the base class, but now you substitute an object of the derived class and supply it to that same test, why would you think that the test would fail? Is there a technical reason for you to believe that the test will fail? Or you just say, oh, that's not the same implementation, not the same method, it will fail? Because I will say, that's not a sufficient reason for a test to fail. There is a specification of preconditions, postconditions, and invariants for every method you implement. And so, both base and derived class may implement the same method through overriding in the derived class. The point is that the new method implementation must observe the same preconditions as the base implementation. Those are the preconditions to a call. So the method must accept all the values that the base implementation used to accept. If the base implementation used to work for one parameter value and the derived implementation fails, that is the violation of LSP. Because I used to call that method with that value, but now I cannot. That is the violation of LSP. Post conditions. Everything the base implementation promised, you must keep in the derived implementation, in the override. You must stick to all the claims that the base implementation made. You can be stricter than that. You can do more. You can be more strict about some aspects of the result or the side effects or whatever the method is doing. But everything that the base implementation promised, you must promise to in the derived method or otherwise. For example, if I expected a method to always return a positive result because zero and negative are unacceptable results in that operation, I could have had many unit tests that are testing classes of input values and checking whether the result is always positive in all those cases, then I could have found edge cases, corner cases, boundary checks. Each of those would be a unit test. In all those places, a unit test would check whether the result is positive. Now, obviously, the derived implementation, the overridden implementation in the derived class must also return a positive result in all those cases. I don't care whether it is 2 or 5 or 7. I don't care. That could be another test. That is something else. But if the criteria is that the result is always positive, it must be positive. That is about post conditions. And class invariants. Those are the properties of the object that must always hold. It holds. An invariant holds before we call a method, and it must remain true after the method executes. So, quite obviously, any derived implementation must retain all the invariants in the object. So, I ended this conversation with this sentence. Any implementation that satisfies these specifications, preconditions, postconditions, and invariants, is by all means valid, and no unit test must ever fail on it. That is how I see the Liskov principle. Through Boolean properties, Boolean attributes of an object and a method, every attribute property of the object that used to be true in the base implementation of the method must remain true when we override it. There's no magic. You don't say, hey, you have changed the method, it's breaking the LSP. No, it's not. Give me a Boolean function that evaluated to true in the base and now evaluates to false. Then I will say that it breaks LSP. So start thinking like an engineer, okay? When somebody tells me that the implementation, the method is breaking LSP, that the class is breaking LSP, I ask why. And I don't want the answers like, well, I think this. No. Give me the Boolean property that now evaluates to false and used to be true. Start thinking in that way.